to 6 million years ago, is likely, or at least it's possible, that it was deflected. Jupiter is a creator and destroyer of worlds. The storm that we're probably most aware of in that spot, which is Jupiter, is a fascinating world in itself, but equally found to Galileo. Moons are in orbit around it and not around us. And then a rather magical world called Europa were launched in 1977. They arrived at Jupiter in 1979. We're a billion miles away from Earth in interstellar space. It's a tiny little thing on 1990, as it was on its way out of the solar system. It was 4 billion miles from home. It's called the pale blue dot. The Earth, he wrote, is a very small stage in a vast cosmic arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals on the scarcely distinguishable inhabitants.
Hello, Galactic Voyage viewers. Today, we will get to know Jupiter, the largest planet in the solar system. Jupiter is the fifth planet in order of distance from the Sun, and the largest planet in terms of diameter and mass. It has more than twice the mass of all the other planets in the solar system combined. So with Jupiter's day lasting only 10 hours, what do you think the effects of its fast rotation could have on the planet? Share your thoughts in the comments. Jupiter has four large moons discovered by Galileo Galilei: Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto. These moons are called the Galileo moons, and Jupiter has 95 moons in total. Why do you think Jupiter has so many moons? We look forward to hearing your ideas.
Jupiter is a dominant planet in the solar system, in a sense. It's 2.5 times the mass of all the other planets and moons combined. And that means that it is really the only object in the solar system, other than the Sun, that has a quite profound gravitational influence on the rest of the system. For example, the asteroid that wiped out the dinosaurs here on Earth 66 million years ago is likely, or at least it's possible, that it was deflected onto a collision course with Earth by Jupiter. Jupiter is a creator and destroyer of worlds. We have a spacecraft in orbit around Jupiter now called Juno, which is sending back the most remarkable images of the planet. It's a spacecraft that for the first time orbits the north and south pole of Jupiter. When you zoom in, you see images of clouds that look almost like impressionist paintings. The storm that we're probably most aware of on Jupiter is the Great Red Spot, but it is shrinking. So when Galileo saw the storm system, you could have lined up three Earths in that spot, which is the sense of scale of Jupiter. Now it's shrunk, you could only fit about two Earths across the diameter, but it's still a big and long-lived storm. Jupiter is a fascinating world in itself, but equally fascinating is its own mini solar system. Its moons, over 70 moons, and the four brightest were discovered by Galileo. These moons played an extremely important role in the history of human thought because they confirmed to Galileo, we are not the center of the universe. Because when you look at Jupiter through a telescope, it's obvious that those moons are in orbit around it and not around us. Those moons are worlds with their own characters. Io is the most volcanically active body in the solar system. And then a rather magical world called Europa, a moon covered in a shell of frozen water ice. But we know that beneath that shell of water ice, there is an ocean of liquid salt water. It contains more water than all the oceans of the Earth combined. And so Europa may well be a home for life. Now, we got our first pictures of the planet, and particularly the moons, from two iconic spacecraft, Voyager 1 and Voyager 2. These spacecraft were launched in 1977. They arrived at Jupiter in 1979. We are still in touch with them both today, 41 years after they were launched. Voyager 1 is 13.3 billion miles away from Earth in interstellar space. It's a tiny little thing. I want to show you this photograph of me standing in front of a scale model of it at JPL in California. It's a remarkable engineering achievement. On Valentine's Day 1990, as it was on its way out of the solar system, it took what I think is the most famous image, certainly of Earth, in the history of space exploration, when it was 4 billion miles from home. It's called the pale blue dot image. Now, there are colored stripes crossing the image, which are lens flare. But if you look carefully, in a red stripe, you'll see a point of light, which is our planet, the Earth, the pale blue dot. Carl Sagan, one of my great heroes, wrote a very powerful piece of prose about this image, reflecting on what it tells us about our place in the universe. The Earth, he wrote, is a very small stage in a vast cosmic arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and emperors, so that in glory and in triumph they could become the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Think of the endless cruelties visited by the inhabitants of one corner of this dot on the scarcely distinguishable inhabitants of some other corner of the dot. How frequent their misunderstandings, how eager they are to kill one another, how fervent their hatreds, our posturings, our imagined self-importance, the delusion that we have some privileged position in the universe, are challenged by this point of pale light. This idea that Jupiter might represent humility, the beginnings of the realization that we are perhaps more fragile, small, and more interdependent both with each other and the wider universe than we often like to imagine, I find fascinating in the context of tonight's performance. It holds Jupiter, after all, contains one of the most well-known passages in classical music, the lyrical section that became the patriotic hymn, I Vow to Thee, My Country. Patriotism, the love of country, these are important ideas, they were important to Holst. But so too is the idea that we are one civilization living together precariously on one planet in an ever-changing and always challenging universe. If we are to avoid Sagan's endless cruelties of history, we must find a way to reconcile our affection for our countries with our responsibility to protect our home world by working together. It's my view that the exploration of space has helped deliver this perspective.
Jupiter also has rings, but they are not like Saturn's rings, which are made of ice, but of dust, and they are very faint. Have you ever wondered why the rings are so faint? Let's discover together. Jupiter is one of the brightest objects in the sky in the solar system, second only to the Moon, Venus, and sometimes Mars. Even with a small telescope, the colorful band structures in Jupiter's atmosphere and the Galileo moons can be easily observed. Do you know why these band structures in Jupiter's atmosphere are formed? We are waiting for your answers in the comments. Jupiter's atmosphere is composed mainly of hydrogen and helium and has three main cloud layers: ammonia ice at the top, ammonium hydrosulfide in the middle layer, and water ice and vapor at the bottom. Did you know that wind speeds can reach 540 kilometers per hour near the equator? Let's discuss the effects of this speed on the planet. One of the most prominent features of Jupiter's atmosphere is the Great Red Spot. This giant hurricane covers an area larger than the Earth and has been observed to gradually decrease in size. But why do you think we don't know why this hurricane is getting smaller? Share your theories. As you go deeper into Jupiter's atmosphere, pressure and temperature increase rapidly. The pressure at the center can reach an average of 40 million times the atmospheric pressure at the Earth's surface, so hydrogen cannot maintain its gaseous form, but becomes liquid. This means that Jupiter has the largest oceans in the solar system, but they are made of liquid hydrogen, not water. Similar to Earth, Jupiter's atmosphere produces auroras, northern and southern lights. But the aurora structures on Jupiter are much larger and hundreds of times more energetic. What do you think could be the source of Jupiter's impressive light shows? Share in the comments. Jupiter has a diameter 11 times larger than Earth and can fit 1,300 Earths. What do you think about the size of Jupiter? Share with us if you have any interesting facts about Jupiter's gigantic size. Jupiter is known as a planet in the solar system that has no potential to harbor life, but some of its moons are thought to harbor life. Do you think there could be life on Jupiter's moons? We want to hear your ideas. 10 things you should know about Jupiter. It is the largest planet in the solar system, both in mass and diameter. It is a gas giant and may have an Earth-sized solid core. With 95 natural satellites, it has the largest number of satellites in the solar system. It has rings. To date, 9 spacecraft have visited Jupiter. Although Jupiter does not have the characteristics to harbor life as we know it, it is thought that some of the moons of the planet have oceans of liquid water under the icy surface. In its atmosphere is a giant hurricane called the Great Red Spot, larger in diameter than Earth's. One Jupiter year is equal to 12 Earth years. It is the planet with the shortest day length. Jupiter's rotation around itself takes an average of 10 hours. It is the largest celestial body in the solar system after the Sun, has the strongest magnetic field. Since the pressure is very high in the depths of its atmosphere, Jupiter is thought to have diamond moons. What was the most interesting fact about you? Don't forget to share with us in the comments. Which planet would you like us to talk about in the next video? We look forward to your feedback. See you on the next galactic voyage adventure. With love, in the depths of the solar system.